Hello and welcome back. This is Kiran Shinde. In my last video lecture, we discussed about the concept of virtualization along with the types of virtualization. In today's video lecture, we will talk about the very important component or the key component of virtualization technique, and that's virtual machine. So let's begin. First of all, let us understand what you mean by a virtual machine. A virtual machine is a software implementation of a machine or a computer that executes programs like a real machine. So essentially, it's nothing but a logical view of your actual physical machine. Let's try to understand one more concept in line with VM, that is virtual machine monitor. The host software that provides virtualization is often referred to as a virtual machine monitor or hypervisor. The main software layer or the major software which is responsible for creating the virtual machine is called as virtual machine monitor. The virtual machine monitor gives each virtual machine an illusion of a complete computer to itself. It means the VM can be used as if you are using an actual physical machine. Virtual machine monitor, which is also called as hypervisor, is the actual software layer which provides the virtualization. We will see there are some types exist in line with hypervisor. With this simple image, you can see that at the bottom side, there is virtual machine monitor, that's the software. And on the top of it, we can create the various virtual machines. Now, here we come with a very important concept in line with virtualization, and that's architecture interface. What do you mean by architecture interface? Virtualization can take place at three different stages. First, instruction set architecture, second, application binary interface, and third, application programming interface. Now try to understand these three interfaces with this particular diagram in a more clear way. Here you can see there are some numbers which are associated with every interface here. You can see at number 3 and 4, the instruction set architecture interface is mentioned along with the operating system. On top of it, you can see the serial number 2 is signifying about some libraries, system libraries. And at number 1, you can see the application programs with application programming interface. Now let's try to understand these three or these four different serial numbers which are allotted to the interfaces. Now, if you see this particular image, which is very simple to understand the importance of these interfaces, ISA, that is instruction set architecture, which situates between the operating system and the hardware. Essentially, ISA is useful for establishing the interaction between your operating system and the hardware, actual hardware. If you see at the bottom level, it's the hardware and the OS. In between, you can see the ISA. Now, moving ahead, you can see the system calls are mentioned here. System calls are actually used to establish the communication between operating system and the system libraries. And then on top of libraries, you can see the API calls or the application programming interface, which is essential to establish the communication between the application software and the libraries. So why we are discussing all these interfaces? Because depending on these interfaces, the virtual machines are created. And as per their creation, they are utilized, right? So these interfaces are very, very important to be understood. So let's proceed further to the topic, which is virtual machine types. Virtual machines are separated in two major categories based on their use and degree of their correspondence to any real machine. Now let's see the types so that you will understand why these categories are actually built up. The first type is called as SVM or System Virtual Machine, which provides a complete system platform which supports the execution of a complete operating system. Now, if you remember, last time in my last video lecture, we have discussed about full virtualization and para-virtualization. So, system virtual machine can be viewed as a type of full virtualization. In contrast to process virtual machine or PVM, it is designed to run a single program, which means that it supports a single process. Means PVM is actually designed to only support a single process, but whereas SVM provides a complete system platform. SVM, sometimes called as hardware virtual machine or HVM, allow the sharing of the underlying physical machine resources between the different virtual machines. Here we can see with the help of image, type 1 and type 2. There are two categories. Essentially, these two categories come along with the hypervisor. So the type 1 system virtual machine, if you see at the bottom side, there is host hardware, actual hardware. On the top of it, you can see the virtual machine monitor software. And on top of VMM, you can see the guest operating system along with various guest applications installed on your virtual machines. In type 2, you can see at the bottom side, there is host hardware. On the top of it, the host operating system is installed. And then on top of host operating system, you can see the virtual machine monitor software installed. And then on top of virtual machine monitor, the various virtual machines are created along with the various guest applications. So these are the two types under system virtual machine, type 1 and type 2. So as I said, if you want to relate this with our previous video lecture, the type 1 can be categorized as full virtualization and type 2 can be categorized as para virtualization. So here it is said that type 1 runs directly on the host hardware. Type 2 runs on the host operating system, which is also called as hosted hypervisor. The primary goals of type 1 are to provide the high performance, and the primary goals of type 2 are ease of construction, installation, and acceptability as per the platform. Then some examples are listed over here in this particular slide. Type 1 examples: VMware ESX Server, Xen OS 370, and type 2 examples, user mode Linux. So students, these are two essential types of system virtual machines. Let's talk about what is PVM or process virtual machine. Process VM adds up layer over an operating system, which is used to simulate the programming environment for the execution of individual process. It means the PVM is essentially built up to provide an executing environment for your process or for your program. It is created when that process is started and destroyed when it exits. Its purpose is to provide a platform independent programming environment. If you see this particular line, platform independent programming environment, what struck your mind is the example of JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine, which is essentially a very, very well-known example of PVM, that is process virtual machine. So here you can see the PVM image, which is also called as application virtual machine, which is created for the process alone and destroyed when the process gets finished. So you can see here the various layers from hardware starting at the bottom, the operating system, the virtualizing software, and the application process. But if you see, all these three entities are abstracted here and combined in one PVM, right? Like the hardware, operating system, and virtualizing software is combined in a PVM. So the process virtual machine essentially offers you all these things. And the top, on top of it, you can actually execute your application or your process. So there are essentially, we can say, two aspects in line with process virtual machines. Multi-program systems, wherein each application is given effectively separate access to resources managed by the operating system. And in case of high-level language virtual machines, programs are written for an abstract machine, which is mapped to real hardware through a virtual machine, and wherein your example of JVM comes into picture. There is one more example I have listed here under high-level language virtual machine, which is a category of PVM, and that is Microsoft CLI or .NET framework. So students, these are some examples of PVM. So I hope you understood whatever we discussed in this particular video lecture. Now, in next video lecture, we are going to talk about VMware. So thank you. Thank you for watching.